In the meantime, of video game retailer GameStop is set to continue their head-spinning ascent today. Shares are now up more than 60% pre-market amid an ongoing battle between bullish day traders and hedge fund short sellers that have bet against the stock. GameStop shares have now risen some 700% year-to-date. Christine Romans is here with us on this story. Christine, I look at this price action and it's absolutely eye-watering. The market analyst in me is cringing at the frothiness and all the analogies that we can make here. But there is a story here beneath the surface of hedge fund, the big guys shorting this, and smaller players, retail investors, buying it and making windfall profits, at least on paper.
At the expense of those short sellers. I mean, it's like a David versus Goliath story, or it's a storyline in the TV show Billions, or it's a Michael Lewis story novel. You know, it's all of those things wrapped in one. It's so interesting. And people keep talking about it and talking about GameStop. Look, the fundamentals of the company have been rough here. You know, they're not making any money. They've been closing stores. You see these big short positions in the stock. And then this Reddit board, this WallStreetBets Reddit message board. It's almost like a populist trader uprising to support the stock with these buying of the out of the money options and really hurting the big guys. So it's just been this interesting revolt that somebody's making a lot of money on, someone is not, and certainly is far out of line with the fundamentals of this company. You know, it's funny, in some cases people think it's sort of funny how regular day traders could distort a stock price so much, but one wonders what they think about this at the Securities and Exchange Commission. You know, is it manipulation or is it just fair and square talking up a stock? It's fascinating.
I know. There's a lot of mom and pop investors here that could be cheering at this moment and could end up in tears. And your point about the regulators here is absolutely pivotal for me. I mean, step forward Gary Gensler, the former Wall Street guy that's now going to head up the SEC. This is fresh meat, I think, for the regulators and those voices, particularly in the Democratic Party, that will be like, we need to regulate hedge funds. Enough of what we've seen. Go on, go for it.
it's so interesting because some of the chatter on these message boards is about how this is just desserts for the bloodthirsty short sellers, you know, who are constantly out there making money on weakness in companies, or sometimes not even weakness in companies. So there's a sort of a feeling of righteousness among some of the people who are playing this game. But I mean, they're going after other names this morning too. So I think this is also kind of a story of the frothiness of the market overall, where you've got story stocks that are getting so much attention and so much hype here. There's just a lot of money at work in the market. There's a lot of interest from retail investors in the market. And now these story stocks, I think, have really gained a lot of attention here. Maybe not warranted, but gained a lot of attention. Someone's going to be hurting when this thing turns, but for now, it's not turning.
Yeah. Froth, not fundamentals. We are two people and one mind. I flatter myself. Christine Romans, thank you as always.